Today, Americans are focused on the oversized influence of the oil companies and others through the Occupy Wall Street movement. Yet Republicans are pushing their own pre-Occupy movement in the hopes that Americans will be too preoccupied with this one loan to a clean energy company that they won't see the tens of billions of dollars in government subsidies given to the oil, coal, and nuclear industries, the Republican favorites. The result, we're getting a distorted picture of the real market conditions that threaten our economic future. Who we should really be talking about are not the bureaucrats at DOE, but the bureaucrats in China, who have made a strategic decision to drive foreign competitors out of the solar market. They did it with the rare earth minerals industry in the 1990s, and they are doing it right now with the solar industry. Secretary Chu, many of my colleagues on this committee think renewable energy is the stuff of the Jetsons. They think solar panels are just like flying cars or life-size robots that do housework, maybe someday way in the future. They're completely oblivious to the revolution that is going on. Mr. Secretary, last year globally, 194,000 megawatts of new electrical generating capacity was installed on the planet. What percentage of that new electrical generation power came from renewable sources? One half of it in 2010. Half. And solar is by far the fastest growing energy industry in the world. Over the last 5 years, global solar installments have increased 1,000% to 17,400 megawatts in 2010. For every new nuclear power plant globally that went online last year, four times as much new solar capacity was deployed. In the U.S., there are now 85,000 employees in the coal industry, 85,000 employees in the wind industry, and 100,000 employees in the solar industry. That's the story here. Solar has big coal and big nuclear, and the established energy sector scared stiff, and they've enlisted the Republican Party to do something about it. That's the real story here. The Republicans have now essentially eliminated loan guarantees for renewable energy this year, and they've left $30 billion for nuclear and coal as loan guarantees. They've passed legislation to cut the solar research budget for next year by 64%, but they've increased the budget for nuclear and fossil energy. In their budget, they've promised to cut clean energy investments by 90% over the next 3 years. Historically, just as there has been a Moore's Law for computer chips, there also has been a Moore's Law for solar. For every doubling of solar deployments worldwide, the price declines by 18%. At least that was the case until this year. Through the first 8 months of this year, the price of solar panels has fallen 42%, a 42% drop in just 8 months. So the irony here is that the Republicans attack renewable energy because they claim it's too expensive. But Solyndra failed because solar is getting too cheap. The price of solar and wind and other clean energy is dropping while coal and oil prices have risen. And the Republicans and the fossil fuel industry can't let clean energy win. And why has this happened? Why has there been a 42% drop? I will tell you why. Our country is in a race right now. There's a global race to become the leading maker of solar technology, and we have some fierce competitors. Last year alone, China gave five solar companies $31 billion in financing assistance. That's on top of free land, extensive tax breaks. That's on top of a domestic currency that is substantially undervalued, and allegations of dumping by Chinese state-sponsored solar companies into the U.S. market by our solar industry. Secretary Chu, do you agree that this massive intervention into the market by China has fundamentally altered the market for solar panels and, in fact, made it very difficult for solar, for evergreen, for energy conversion devices in Michigan to survive, that the prices have plummeted. And just like Pets.com in the dot-com bubble, there are individual companies that are going to fail inside of a larger success story for solar and renewables.
Yes, I agree with that. Certainly, as I've indicated before, China has targeted all renewable energies as on their critical path for their future prosperity, not only for their domestic use, and they're going to be the leading user of renewable energies, but also they see a huge export market.
So when the price of silicon dropped dramatically, 90%, that hurt the technology of Solyndra because it was something that they were depending upon to have a much higher price point,
right,
and that price point collapsed for them.
That is correct. Silicon and solar modules in general dropped, you said 42% in 8 or 9 months and 70% in a couple of years. That's unheard of, and it was violating the learning curve, the Moore's Law you spoke about.
What happened with cell phone prices because of action in this. The price dropped 90% for cell phones after we passed three bills out of this committee. We don't mourn the old brick size of phones. We all started to put those phones at under 10 cents a minute in our pocket.
Time.
That's what's happening in the solar market.
Gentlemen's time.